Sanskritam Naram Seva Narottamam Devim Sarasatim Vyasam Tataja Mujarayat Mukam Karati Vatalam Pangulam Haitigirim Dat Kripa Tamaham Bande Paramananda Madhavam Siguru Dhritaranam Sri Chaitanya Ishwara. Hare Krishna. So nice to be with all of you again this year. So once a year I visit this temple. Although this temple is my base, from here I travel all over America. So today I'll speak very briefly because already a lot of announcements have been done. So class is less. And at the end, I will give some presentation. India tribal care. Last year, I had given some presentation. So how things are improving, how important it is. The tribal care is very serious situation in India. India is facing. So it is so serious. If it is not addressed now, by next 40-50 years, even if in India, we cannot do kirtan loudly. It's so dangerous now. State after state, 99% people are converted to other religions. It's a big challenge in India. So I will give some presentation on that. So what we'll do, we'll read from Srimad Bhagavatam. So they bring auspiciousness to all of us, Srimad Bhagavatam. So we have done Bhakti Riksha program day for yesterday. Bhakti Riksha devotees are here for a year class day for yesterday. That day, I wanted to give class in the first verse of Bhagavatam. So I was holding it then to the audience to bring them to the point to listen this topic. I have to say something else, I cannot start it. So today, at least I'll start it, the verse. I've given some preface on that day. So probably here, from Srimad Bhagavatam. Om Nama Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Nama Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Nama Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Nama Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
So this is the first line of Srimad Bhagavatam. So when we give any class, we may chant this mantra, Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. But this is Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. This is not just a line that what we chant before giving any class. This is the first line of Srimad Bhagavatam. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. So that indicates that before we start reading Srimad Bhagavatam, or anyone wants to read Bhagavatam, anyone wants to understand Bhagavatam, anyone wants to realize Bhagavatam, he has to first say Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. So what does this mean? So this means that I accept the son of Vasudev, Vasudev Krishna, he is Supreme Personality of Godhead. If somebody is not accepting this, then he has no qualification to enter into Bhagavatam. So that's why before we study Bhagavatam, first we study Bhagavad Gita. By reading Bhagavad Gita, when we understand from the teachings of Bhagavad Gita, what Arjuna has declared, Param Brahma, Param Dhamam, Pavitram, Paramam Bhavan, that you are the Param Brahma. And in conclusion, Krishna is saying, Sarva Dharman Paritejya Mam Ekam Saranam Braja. So those that have accepted Krishna as the Supreme Personality of Godhead, in more detail, they have accepted Ekala, Ishwara, Krishna are Sabhritya. Ekala means only Krishna. and all others are his servants. Then following his instructions, they have given up everything, completely surrendered to Krishna. Sarvadharman parityajya mamekam saranam braja. Then you enter into Srimad Bhagavatam by addressing Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. I offer my obeisances. I offer my namaskar. You know the meaning of namaskar. What is the meaning of namaskar? In Bhagavad Gita, Krishna is saying, no. Last instruction, manmana, bhava madbhakta, madjaji, manmana. You think about me. You meditate upon me. How you think, how you meditate upon me? Not like conscious meditating. Always about Krishna, yes? Hiranyakashipu meditating about on Vishnu also, always thinking Vishnu, Vishnu, where is Vishnu? I think Hiranyakashipu is more serious searching for Vishnu than us. Ravan, when Rama will come? They are all eagerly waiting, we don't have that much eagerness. Kansa is the best Krishna conscious person. It has been stated that Kansa, if he climbs some staircase, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Asanas will put his feet on 8th step. Immediately remember Krishna, the 8th son of Devaki. See? Just like gopis. Then Krishna is worried. I told Manmana, you think about me? And if, what if people think about me like Kansa, Ravana and Hiranyakashipu? He's clarifying it. No. Not like that. Think about me, Manmana, Bhava Madhvakta. How you think about me? The way my devotee they think about me. Anukulyana Krishna, not pratikul, the anukul bhav, in favorable mood. Manmana bhava madhvakta. So who is my devotee? Special among Hindus. Oh, everything is okay. All gods are same, right? It's very common concept among Hindus. Whomever you worship, you go to the same destination. So Krishna knows that. I told people to become devoted, then they will misinterpret. Anybody you worship, you go to Krishna. No. Madjaji. Only those they worship me. Clarify one after another. Because Krishna knows how expert we are in speculation. Not speculating. So he's clarifying. Manmana. How Manmana? Madhvakta. Who is Madhvakta? Madjaji. Then he's coming to conclusion. Mam namaskar. Don't be worried, it's not just a difficult job. To worship me is very simple. Shastra may describe so many ways for worshipping. There are 16 upachar, 16 elements that we offer to Krishna. And Krishna is so kind, so merciful. Then he's saying, if nothing you can do, just if we are doing now, flower, water, pradeep, and incense, 16 items are there. And out of 16 items, one item is offer obeisances. Very expensive to offer obeisances. It may not be very expensive, but very difficult to bow down. So Krishna said, if nothing can do, mang namaskuru. At least offer a pranam, offer a namaskaran to me. Very simple. Is it difficult?
No.
Is it difficult?
No.
You are all ready for offering obeisance and namaskar?
Yes.
But now you understand the meaning of namaskar. The meaning of namaskar is that na mama, when you say somebody namaskar, namaste ji, that means na mama te, nothing belongs to me. My house, bank balance, wife, children, everything I give to you. That is namaskar. And Krishna is very expert. He's a very simple to worship me, just say namaste. But behind namaste, he has a big meaning. Right? And just start with namaste. Start with namaste. Then he explains the next verse, the meaning of namaste. The meaning of namaste means sarvadharman parityajya mamekam saranam. So this is how her Gita ends. Teachings of her teaching Gita ends. Sarva dharman paritej. The teachings of Bhagavatam starts from there. dharma prajjita kaitava. That is a very big topic. I don't want to get into that. Otherwise, I will miss today also. Reading this verse. So, we will read this verse today. So, this verse explaining very important subject matter. Prabhupada is saying that any scriptures, also you see any Purana, any religion, they start with creation, how creation takes place. So, taking a verse, concept of from Vedanta Sutra, the Bhagavatam starts with Janmadasya jata anyar itarata sarthasya abhigya surat tene brahma jidaja adhikavaye mujjanti jata suraya teja bari mridang jatha vinimaya jatra tisarkam nisam dhamna svena sada nirasta kuhakam satyam param dhimahi. Meditating upon Satyam Param Dhimahi. Param Dhimahi. I do meditate upon the Absolute Truth. So who is that Absolute Truth? That is Krishna. Krishna is controller, he is the Supreme. Krishna is Ishwar. Is Krishna only Ishwar? Is Krishna only Ishwar or he has some specific designation? Ishwara?
Parameshwara.
So Ishwara, Parameshwara, in between Ishwara and Parameshwara, there is another Ishwara. Any of you know?
Maheshwara.
You are all Ishwara or not Ishwara?
Yes.
Because you are also controller, no? Yes. Ishwara is controller. But you are all mini Ishwara. Rupa is saying. We are mini-Ishwara. And above us, no, there is Ishwara, Indra, Chandra, Varuna, they are controller, no? Vayu Devata, Agni, they are Ishwara. Then above them, Maheshwara. Then above them,
Parameshwara.
So Rama is Ishwara, Maheshwara or mini-Ishwara?
Parameshwara.
Narayana?
Parameshwara.
Narasimha?
Parameshwara.
And Krishna?
Parameshwara.
So what is special about Krishna then? Krishna, Rama Bhagavan, Vamana Bhagavan, Narasimha Bhagavan, but Krishna is? Swayam Bhagavan. So Rama Parameshwara, Vamana Parameshwara, Narasimha Parameshwara, so Krishna is?
Swayam
Parameshwara. He is Paratpara Parameshwara. You understand? He is Paratpara Parameshwara. So that is position. So he is Satyam Param Dhimahi. By writing this, Vyasadeva addressing Janma Dasya Jataha. Janma Adi Asya Jataha. Jata means from whom everything has manifested. Asya means this cosmic manifestation. Janma Adi. Janma means creation, maintenance, annihilation. So, who is creator? Who is creator?
Brahma.
Among three gods, who is creator?
Brahma.
But Brahma is not real creator. Brahma is secondary creator. There is sarga means creation, upasarga means secondary creation. So Brahma only takes the elements and put together to give a shape. But prior to Brahma, there is another creator. Who is that creator?
Vishnu.
Who created Brahma?
Vishnu.
So Vishnu. There are three Vishnu. Kshirodaksha Vishnu, Gaurodaksha Vishnu, Karmadaksha Vishnu. So Brahma coming from which Vishnu?
Garbha
Vishnu. Gaurodaksha Vishnu is real. Creator. So where is Garbhodaksha Vishnu coming from?
Mahavishnu.
Where is Mahavishnu coming from?
Krishna.
Krishna, directly.
Sankara.
Okay. So I will come from the top. Instead of going bottom, I will come to the top. So who is on the top?
Krishna.
Who is Krishna?
Vishnu.
There are two Krishnas. You know two Krishnas? I think there are three Krishnas. In our material world, only one Krishna goes from Vrindavan to Mathura, Mathura to Dwaraka. But spiritual world, Krishna is one. There is Dwaraka Krishna, one Mathura Krishna, and one Vrindavan Krishna also. There are three Krishnas are there. So, Vrindavan Krishna, Dwaraka Krishna is Purna, Mathura Krishna is Purnatara, Vrindavan Krishna is Purnatama. But this Vrindavan Krishna is the topmost. That is Krishna and Balaram, son of Nanda Maharaj Krishna. And in Vrindavan, their mood is Gopo Bhava and Gopo Besa. Their mood is cowherd boy mood and dressed like cowherd boy. And that Krishna and Balaram, then they manifest in Dwaraka, from Vrindavan to Dwaraka. So in Vrindavan, Krishna's name is Nanda Nandan Krishna. And Dwaraka, his name is? Anybody knows? In Dwaraka, Krishna's name is? Vasudeva Krishna. There his son of Vasudeva. Vrindavan, his son of Nanda Maharaj. Is Vasudeva, Vasudeva. Vasudeva is Om Nama Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Okay? Is Vasudeva Krishna. And here in Vrindavan, his elder brother known as Balaram. And Dwaraka is known as? Anybody knows? Sankarsan. He is known as Mula Sankarsan. Do you remember? In Vrindavan, Nanda Nandana Krishna and Balaram. And they manifest in Dwaraka as Vasudeva Krishna and the Mula Sankarsana. Then Pradyumna Aniruddha in four forms and the Lord manifests there in Dwaraka. Then from Dwaraka you go to Vaikuntha. In Vaikuntha, this Mula Sankarsana, he manifests as Mahasankarsana. Baladeva, Mula Sankarsana, Mahasankarsana. Then Mahasankarsana, he manifests as Mahavishnu. Mahavishnu expands to? Which Vishnu? Garbhadaksha Vishnu. Garbhadaksha Vishnu expands to? Kshirodaksha Vishnu expands to? Karudaksha. To Sesa Naga. Sesa means end. So the end, Sesanaga. So now we are discussing about the creation. Who will be the original creator then? We are talking Brahma. Brahma manifesting from? Garbhadaksha Vishnu. Garbhadaksha Vishnu manifesting from? Mahavishnu. Mahavishnu manifesting from? Mahasankarsana. In Vaikuntha. Mahasankarsana manifesting from? Mula Sankarsana. Where? In Dwaraka. And Mula Sankarsana manifesting from? Baladev in Vrindavan. Baladev manifesting from? Krishna. So who is the original creator?
Krishna.
Sri Janmadasya Jataha. This cosmic manifestation and everything. The creator, maintenance and annihilator. So he is Krishna. Is Krishna really creating? Is he maintaining? Is he annihilating? Krishna creates? He never creates. He never maintains. He is not into all these jhamala problems. He is there in Golok Vrindavan. He simply desires. Tumi sarve sureshwara Brajendra Kumar tomar ichchaya vishwara se janasangha. Sitting there, just playing flute, playing with cowherd boys and all the gopis, no headache. He is Sarveshwareshwara. He is Ishwara of all Ishwara, controller for everybody, topmost personality in Golok Vrindavan, the topmost planet. Bhulaka, Bhuvalaka, Swalaka, Mahalaka, Janalaka, Tapalaka, Satyalaka. Then eight avarana coverings, then Viraja, then Vaikuntha, then Ajodhya, then Dwaraka, then Mathura, then? So far, top of everybody, topmost personality, topmost position, the supreme, supreme personality. At least in Dwaraka, what is being, he is ruling, he is a ruler. But Vrindavan, somebody says, oh, your Bhagavan is very great, the topmost one. But what is doing there? Hold on, what is his business?
Playing flute.
Enjoy. Taking care of cows. Playing flute, okay. But what is daily service?
Cows.
What is your daily job?
Cows.
Grazing cows. Grazing cows. Who grazes cows? Who grazing cows? Cowherd boys. In our village, they say, among all the community, the cowherd people are most less intelligent people. In village, if somebody is used for nothing, okay, you go for grazing the cows. Yeah. In Bengal, they say, cowherd people, when they become 8 years old, they get little intelligence. It's a very interesting question. The supreme personality of Godhead, he could not get any other business to do. He's a topmost person, big office, big sister, something. But he took up a very interesting job. The most less intelligent person, the most foolish people, whose brain has nothing to do. Can't do anything, you go for grazing cows. He take up that service. Why? He's very intelligent. He's most intelligent. He gave all this job. Vishnu, you maintain. Brahma, big, big position. No? Brahma, Vishnu, Maheshwar. What will you do? I'll do grazing the cows. But you are the lord of all the lords. Yes, that's why I'll do grazing the cows. So what is the secret? The secret is, if I go for grazing the cows, I don't have to go for stress management anymore. So I give all the stress to everybody. So that's why he has Ichha Shakti. Krishna, Nandanandana Krishna, Ichha Shakti, desire. Vasudeva Krishna, Jnana Shakti. That's why we are saying, Om Namo Bhagavata Vasudevaya, Jnana Shakti. Then Balaram is Kriya Shakti. Crystal simple desire. As soon as he desires, then Vasudeva Krishna is there. The Jnana starts to work, knowledge. Then Balaram is there, the Kriya Shakti, all activities start. You understand? The whole chemistry is there. How this whole cosmic manifestation come into existence. And Bhagavata describes everything. 10 subject matters described in Srimad Bhagavatam. Atra sarga visargascha sthanam posanam utaya manvantara isanukatha nirodha mukti asraya. These 10 topics you will find in this book. Atra sarga. Sarga means about creation. Visarga about secondary creation. Sthanam. The location of all the planetary systems, everything described here. Every planet from each other, how much distance, everything is given here. Sthanam. Then Poshanam, how Lord is maintaining everybody, especially his devotees. Sthanam, Poshanam. Then Utayaha, the Karmabhasana. Karmabhasana, because of which from time immemorial, the living entities traveling from species to species, punarapi janamam, punarapi maranam, punarapi janani jathare, sayanam, utaya karmavasana, sthanam, posanam, utaya. Then manvantara, our ruling of different manu, manvantara periods, isanukatha, isa means Ishwara Bhagavan, different pastimes of Ishwara also isanukatha, nirodha, nirodha means he, just like creation takes place from a subtle matter to gross matters, from sky to air to fire to water to earth. Same way, Nirodha means how this cosmic manifestation winds up from gross to subtle, then merge into Mahavishnu's body. That's called Nirodha. Then Mukti, liberation. Then Ashraya, then all these 9 subjects were holy, that is Krishna, Ashraya. These 10 subject matters are described in Srimad Bhagavatam. So first thing starts with janmadasya jataha. Now in India, so many Bhagavans are there. First of all, Hindus, they believe in many gods. A Muslim, only one, Allah, that's it. Christians, one God. Hindus, how many gods? Huh? Only 330 million gods. But they don't know this, what is God, what is demigod, Devata Bhagavan. And Hindus are so fond of gods, 330 million gods are not sufficient. You go to India, so many, this Baba, that Baba, this Thakur, so many new gods. And I think they have more followers than the real gods. Yes. And people are after that. But now here the first verse saying, who can be God? Janmadasya jataha. One who is responsible, who is that powerful, the whole cosmic manifestations come to existence, created, maintained and annihilated. And our foolish people in India should ask to their God, are you the cause of whole creation? Are you maintaining the whole universe? Are you the cause of all the destruction of the universe? So Prabhupada is saying, the first symptom of God, the Swarup Lakshan, the Tatastha Lakshan and Swarup Lakshan is given here. So in this way, we should first understand Satyam Param Dhimahi. I am meditating upon that absolute truth. So Prabhupada in its purport is describing that absolute truth, meditating, that is Lord Krishna. We simply by his desire, Tumi Sarve Swareswara Brajendra Kumar, Tumar Ichha Vishwara Siddhana Sangha. By his desire, Tava Ichhamate Brahma Karana Srijana, Tava Ichhamate Vishnu Karana Palana, Tava Ichhamate Siv Karana Sanghara, Tava Ichhamate Maya Sridhya Karaga. Okay? You understood? Yes? By your desire, Brahma is creating, Vishnu maintaining, and Shiva annihilating, and Durga Maya Devi has created this Karaga, Sansara Karaga. And we are put into the samsara karagar. And many poets, many philosophers, they say, oh, God has sent us to a very nice place to enjoy our life. That's a misconception. This is not a nice place, this is a place where people, every living entity, they have to go through the cycle of birth and death. Then how is a nice place? And especially this body is given for us to suffer here, not to enjoy. This misconception of our life is that we should enjoy, but this body is meant for suffering. So those two points also made over here. That Supreme Personality of Godhead, who knows everything, he is Swarag, he is independent, and he is the person who first gave Tene Brahma Hridayo Adhikavaye. The first living entity in this universe is Brahma. And Lord Narayan, he imparted the Veda to Brahma. And somewhere it has been stated that Brahma is completely bewildered. And Brahma has created his Ajani Sambhuta. He has no mother. He appeared on the top of the lotus flower, which emanated from the navel of Garbhadaksha Vishnu. And Lord Krishna, he played flute. By the flute sound, Brahma became fully conscious. And that's why it has been described that God created two worlds. One is Dhamna Swena Sada Nidastha Kuhakam, the spiritual world, which is never influenced by modes of material nature. Completely spiritual, controlled by Yoga Maya. Then another, this material world, Tejabari Mrida, Jatha Vinimaya, Jatha Trisarga Mrisa. This material world which is created by the interaction of three modes of material nature. Here we see Tejabari Mrida. Here we see, this translation Prabhupada, he has mentioned how people are bewildered. The material universe is temporarily manifestation of three modes of material nature. And here we see, on land we see water, like a mirage. It's like a mirage. Material world is like a mirage. On land we see water. Where you see water on the land? Where you see water in, in the desert. There are some people they see, they say, oh, Brahma Satya Jagat Mithya. So they just conclude like that. No, because this whole world is just like mirage. But in mirage, what do you see? In mirage, what do you see?
Water.
Is there water there?
No.
There is no water there. Is there water somewhere?
Yes.
Otherwise, how would you conclude there is some water? So where is that water?
Somewhere.
Where is that somewhere? That is in spiritual world. So that is what Bhagavatam trying to conclude. Otherwise, some people they say, just mirage. Get rid of this. No. There is water somewhere. I mean, mirage, that is no water. Otherwise, why you are saying, where is the concept of water come at all? So that means that the place for supreme bliss. That is Satyam Param Dhimahi. And Prabhupada explaining, here is everything relative, nothing absolute in this material world, because anything to be proved depends upon something else. But spiritual world, nothing depends. Nobody depends upon anybody. In the spiritual world, you don't depend, you don't have to work, go to job to get money to maintain your family. You don't have to do that. What you have to do, then how you get your necessary things? There are kalpavrikshas are there. What is kalpavriksha in English?
Desire
trees. Just go under the desire tree, say, give me one box of rasgola, then you'll get rasgola. Whatever you want, you'll get there, so no problem. Very nice, right? How nice it would be if we had one tree like that. But interestingly, in the spiritual world, there are kalpavriksha, which are meant you go under that tree, whatever you desire, you'll get it. But interestingly, people have no desire to get it there. They have no desire to get anything. So that tree is only there where people have no desire. That tree is not here where we have desire. We don't have that. The spiritual is only one desire. Have to serve the Lord. They get that ananda, that bliss. We don't get that bliss here. Our bliss, our ananda is different than the ananda in the spiritual world. So our ananda in this material world, called jodananda, jodo ananda, material pleasure. Even swargaloka, bhulaka, bhulaka, material pleasure. Then when you get liberation, go to Brahma Jyoti, there you get a Brahmananda. So who knows the difference between ananda in this material world and ananda in Brahma Jyoti? Anybody knows? I just described in that Bhakti Vriksha members, remember? What is the pleasure that we consider in this material world? And what is the pleasure in Brahma Jyoti? Anybody remembers? None of you? Let's go to the Krishna chance to explain you again. So, yes, Prabhuji?
Material and ananda is not permanent.
That is one criteria. Material pleasure is not pleasure. The reductions of suffering, that is called material pleasure. Reduction of suffering. You understand? Only suffering. Like suffering reduce. Oh, I am so happy. You understand? You work whole week like a donkey. Then weekend, to reduce your suffering, go to sea beach, cinema, oh, I am enjoying. But not enjoying. Rupa saying you are trying to forget your suffering. That is material enjoyment. Okay? That is your jodananda. Then, Brahmananda, the ananda, the jnanis they get when they merge into Brahman effulgence. What is that ananda? Is there any ananda? That is absence of sufferings. Two words, please remember. Material world pleasure is reduction of suffering. Okay. Brahmananda is absence of suffering. There is no, yes, there is no enjoyment, no pleasure, but no suffering there. That's it. That also regarded as a pleasure. So, Jadananda, Brahmananda. Then beyond that, in spiritual world, what do Ananda get? Huh? So, Premananda. Paramananda, not Paramananda, Premananda. That you develop love. You cannot develop love in this material world. What can you develop in this material world? Lust. You can develop a lust only, no love here. I may say, oh, I love you so much. Actually, I lost on you so much. Not love. And Brahma Jyoti, whom to love there? And only Jyoti, what do you love? Only Jyoti. But spiritual world, then Premananda. So Jadananda, Brahmananda, highest is Premananda. Then higher than Premananda is Atananda. That is called Sevananda. Yes. Pure devotees, top class Prema Bhakti. Who are they? Among all devotees, the topmost Prema. Who? And Gopis, Mother Adharani. So Chaitanya Charitamrita describing when Gopis and Radharani, they are fanning Krishna. So Krishna Prem arises, no? When Krishna Prem will arise, what will happen? What are the symptoms of Krishna Prema? Huh? Romance kampa, tears will come, they'll become stunned. So the Gopis, they are saying, oh Prem, please stay away from us. We have no time to entertain you. We are obstructing in our service. We cannot fan Krishna. We decorated ourselves so nicely to give pleasure to Krishna. If tears comes, our eyes will become very ugly. So Krishna will not enjoy. So higher than Premananda is Sevananda. By serving Krishna, they enjoy so much. They tell Prema, you please stay away for some time. Don't disturb me here now. Now you understand what highest subject matter being spoken in this Srimad Bhagavatam. Dharma prajjita kaitavatra parama nimastranam satang prema pumartha mahan. The pancham purusartha I described in Bhakti Vriksha that day. What are the chari purusarthas for? Goals of life? Any of that Bhakti Vriksha members remember? Dharma? Okay, great, good. You must be knowing this before, not from that. Dharmartha kamar, for purusartha. What is the fifth one?
Prema pumartha.
Prema pumartha mahan. Krishna prema. So very confidential subject matter. Vedaratara galitam phalam sukha mukhadamrita dharma sanjutam. The ripe and juicy and sweet fruit of the tree, of Veda tree, is given Srimad Bhagavatam. All of you should read Srimad Bhagavatam. Nityam Bhagavata Sevaya Bhagavati Uttama Salakya Bhakti Bhavati Naistiki. If you take Bhagavatam in your house, means Krishna is in your house. In Kali Yuga, Krishna came in the form of Bhagavatam. How many of you have Bhagavatam sets in your house? How many of you don't have Bhagavatam in your house? Don't feel embarrassed. Raise your hands. No problem. We'll give you a set. No problem. So please take Krishna to your house. No. Bhagavatam, you have a special offer, honor, they can give full set of Bhagavatam, you can decorate your house. And by keeping Bhagavatam in your house, all inauspiciousness will go away. Bhagavad is such a literature, it has been stated, Sadda Ruddha Avaruddha Tatra Kutubi Sushushubi Tatkhana. Other literature, you have to listen, you have to follow, then you get result. But Bhagavatam is such a literature, what to speak of following, what to speak of hearing. Even if you just desire to hear, sitting in our house, thinking, oh, how nice it would be, I could have gone to temple, hear Srimad Bhagavatam. If you just think like this, by that Krishna will be arrested within our heart. Yes, that much powerful literature it is. Janata Viplava. It has power to create whole revolution among the human society. Believe that?
Yes.
It has. Has it started revolution in society?
Yes.
All over the world?
Yes.
So that is Srimad Bhagavatam. Srimad Bhagavatam ki
jai.
Srimad Bhakta Vrinda ki
jai.
Kaur Premanande.
Hello.
So now,